Hello everybody and welcome, this is Chip, and welcome, honestly. Here we are. I never thought I'd make it to this point, but here's the first video of not only my career mode series, but my YouTube channel in general. And I'm really happy to be making this one, really happy to be uploading this. And I decided I was going to pick a team for my career mode, because I don't really have any subscribers right now, besides like my friends, to really ask who I was going to play as. So I decided to pick myself. And I thought I didn't want to pick a team in like a league that everyone used, or a team that everyone would be using. But I wanted to pick a team that had enough money to the fact where I could actually purchase a couple players and change the team in a way. Because like if I'm picking some of these teams, I was searching through Spanish teams because I really wanted to have a team that could compete with Atletico Madrid and Valencia and Real Sociedad and Barcelona and Real Madrid, of course. And I was looking through these teams and just looking at the budgets of some of these teams, like Real Valladolid, I think that's how you pronounce that. But looking at their budget, I mean, $4 million, what am I really going to do to the team with $4 million? So I thought Sevilla, they're a 4-star team, but they're not really one of the better teams in the league, obviously. I think we might be in the Europa League, correct me if I'm wrong, but I mean, that at least gives us some of that. So without further ado, here we go. I decided to put my settings on Euros. I only put it on Sterling, really, if I'm in England, and I'm not, so obviously don't need that. European competition. We are Bordeaux, Motherwell, and... Okay, so we have a very easy group for that, so we'll probably make it in the second round. I'm using the download latest rosters. I don't know if Sevilla made any, like, moves in the, I don't know if they made any moves during the transfer window, so comment in the comments below, please, if they did make a move, make me aware of it. I'd love to know, because I don't really know the roster too well. I know Sevilla used to have Jesus Navas, and for the name, I thought about this one a little bit. This is one me and my friends use a lot. Sir Guppy, because we are always classy, never trashy. And for a country, I randomed a kind of a group, like a language group, or a alphabetical order group to be in. And then I kind of closed my eyes here and picked a team, and El Salvador came up, but I didn't know if they were an actual national team in the game. So I went for another run, and I ended up getting Egypt that time. So we're going to be an Egyptian man coaching Sevilla. Well, I'm pretty sure they fired a, I think they fired their coach this year, correct me if I'm wrong. But I'm pretty sure they fired their coach this season, so that's kind of cool how in real life they fired their coach and now we're taking over. So, can Sevilla live without Medel? So apparently we sold, Medel, the guy in Cardiff City, so apparently we sold him. But in the bottom, I'm getting a signed, a top player thing, so I'm guessing we must have signed someone during the window. You see that, it says Stoke City. This is not my first try at making a team. So, hopefully this one will end up right, and this will be the team we're gonna end up using. So, here we are. Took a good lineup. Ooh, I did not like that funny. Peso, okay, Tiger, Rock. Ooh, Rock, okay, she's a really good player, definitely using him. Abora, Reyes, Patola. You guys can read these for yourself, I believe. Kenya is a really good player now. Marco Marin, the Chelsea man. We're definitely gonna be putting him in our lineup. He's really good player. Not that important, but they're on reserve. Alright, so for the formation, I really thought about this one, and I think I came up with a 4-3-2-1, because it's a formation I'm comfortable with, and I feel like it's a formation that would really work in Spain. Because I know a lot of the teams in Spain are using, have a really big emphasis on midfield, and a lot of teams end up using 3 in the back for this for the purpose of getting more midfielders. So I'm going to be using this formation where I can have those kind of wing sort of players and have like those like kind of like it's like almost a 5 midfield but also a kind of 3 on the wing. But I can do this without having to, you know, kind of forfeit the defensive stability, I guess. And then he's playing Rocket just in the middle of my midfield. He's really just a midfield player on New York City. Actually, I was putting him on my main because in Dia, a holding midfielder, I would like to have a holding guy kind of in the middle in a 4-3-1. And for defense, seems to be good. Wait, put the younger guy in there. Give a younger guy to him. Beto, yeah, he'll be our starting goalie. Alright, well, this is our lineup. And looking at this, honestly, where do we need help? Really in the defense. Actually, I would like to get a left or a right forward. As important as the defense is, you're never going to survive in the League of BBVA without the blade defense. So our goal is to qualify for the Euro League. Our domestic cup objective is to reach the round of 16. So, for a player, I'm going to be going for a right forward. I don't really like the new, the system, what do you call it? What do they call this thing? The Global Transfer Network? I'm not really a big fan of that system, so I'm going to be skipping out on that. Aiden McGee. But I'm looking for really a right wing, right wing, the kind of player where you're right side of the attacker. Del Fu would be a good player to get there. He's on the lane. Hunt Ben Arthur would not be a bad player yet. Something quiet about him. He's really a good player to be a good player. Maybe we can get him back. That's probably why we have that hole, because of him. Israel? Or not a mission, really, but Nani? I'm not gonna go for him. I'm gonna inquire about Raheem Sterling, because I really think he's a really good player. I mean, probably that bias speaking, coming from the Liverpool fan, but whatever, you should have to deal with it, I guess. But yeah, I'm not afraid to talk up my favorite teams to play this season. I really think the position for the left and right forward could be filled by a striker just as well as it can be filled by an actual right winger player. But I'm pretty sure he's on Juventus on loan in real life. I'm pretty sure he should resign so they won't be able to sell him. Of course, we've got to inquire about Lord Bentner. If we can get Lord Bentner, no doubt in my mind. Oh, they do have Luke Young here. I'm also a Dutch national team fan, so I like them. But really, players who are in new spots, so I'm kind of trying to get familiar with that as well. Just as much as I'm trying to get my own team together, but I think we can inquire about a couple players there. One player I really want to work on, I don't know if they'll sell him to me because they are in. They do happen to be in the League of BBV as well. But in the midfield, right mid, I believe, he'd come up as, I forgot to say his name. He does happen to come from this league though, so I don't know if they'll sell him to us. I don't know if they're really rivals. I'm not too familiar with the rivals. Carlos Vela? I would love to get Carlos Vela. And then I'm gonna also be checking the because I know they have really good wingers. The Serie A. Because I just know like wingers in New York's amazing. El Sharawi, all these amazing players. I'm pretty sure Jankovic is a good player. Lichtsteiner, Pepe, Isla, just the list goes on. You got loan from. That's good. It's always good, dude. I hate that. It's like, it's so obnoxious when you find a player who's like recently arrived or is on loan. Like, their name should, I think what would be a great idea to add to FIFA, their name should pop up in a different color. Like, if they're on loan, maybe their name should be yellow. And if they recently signed, it should be like blue or something. If they're gonna retire at the end of the season, make it red. Something like that, just to like kind of make them stand out of the crowd. So no one's gonna be like, oh, I'm gonna go try and sign this player. And then it's like, you inquire about him. So, oh, we recently arrived. Yeah, I kind of noticed that about Osvaldo right after. And I think they just said they wanted me to win the Euro Cup. 17 million, 3.9, 4.7, and 34.5. Hello. Yeah, no, they definitely said they wanted us to win the Euro League. I can see that as a somewhat reasonable goal. It might be because we're a rival that they're saying they want so much for him. Because, I mean, I think we can all realistically say here that's an absolutely preposterous statement. But offer Reyes and him. Bentner, that was more of a joke. Raheem Sterling for $2 million would be an absolute steal of a pickup for that right forward position. And then we could focus on more important things, or important things like the defense as well. Sociedad have come back and they say they don't feel like that's an appropriate amount. I'll tell you what I'll do. I will set it this way. There. And then for Vela, I will go up to 18 million. That gives me enough for him and Sterling, I believe. Who's like just enough. Because if I can get both of them, that'd be amazing. Because I can put one of them striker or left forward, or, you know, in the midfield. Transfer for Beto. Not really interested in selling Beto at this point. I played with him in the game before. He's really a really good keeper, though. I feel like he's under. They want 10.5 now for Sterling. What happened to you guys? I'll offer you 4. Not that I don't think he's worth 10 million. I completely agree with that value. I feel like it's even higher. I feel like he's really undervalued. Well, apparently they're just gonna keep Carlos Vela to themselves, so last ditch attempt right there. Reyes and 20 million. If you guys are willing to accept that, I'm willing to kind of off it. Ooh, there's interesting stuff there. Ooh, you want 110,000 now. Hey there, buddy. Hey there, buddy. Well, I'd love to have you play for Sevilla. I don't know if you'd come over or not, but that's great. And 4 million for Raheem Sterling. Well done. Interesting. We'll have to see if we can get both of them, because I'd love to have both of them on our side. They'd be beautiful. Sterling not really fitting the contract. Vela is. I guess Vela's coming over, and Sterling's just going to have to stay home in England. When we're winning Champions League year in and year out, you're gonna be all sad sitting at Liverpool. Have fun there. Where? Oh, he probably went in the spot that the guy here placed. Wow. Oof, it's very good. Never actually played with him, but I always see these scores a lot. He gets a lot of inform cards, so I figured why not give him a chance. Kevin gave me arrows. Really good. He's on a budget side of Belgrade earlier. FIFA, like the pre-release. I don't know if you guys know, but like I had the pre-release for FIFA. I got access to that, I was lucky enough, and the prices in pre-release are absolutely ridiculous compared to current prices. I'm no like super awesome economist when it comes to like FIFAnomics, but I don't get that. Diego Perotti. Oh my. You guys are willing to offer that, like, 9 million I'm seeing out there? Because I usually like to go off the thing that the chief executive or whatever says. That'd be great. Alright. Transfer offer for Fazio. 8 million for this guy, and you've got him. Because honestly, I can think of a lot of center backs I can get for 8 million that I would absolutely love to have on this team more than Fazio. They've matched it, and they're not willing to go more than 6.5. Well, the top is telling me 7 to 9. So, I'm sorry, Carlos, but you're going to have to go a little bit higher. Players sold. They're not willing to go more than 6.5. I will meet them at 8. Alright, well, thank you guys very much, and I think that's where we're ending part 1 of this series. Hope you guys liked the episode, I hope you guys return for episode 2 and further in the series, and